just a half a metre short, but a foot in touch anyway.
But again, that stem from the scrum half, David Wright, failing to find touch. And when you've got big wings like Tugamala running with the ball, that's very, very difficult. You've got to put the ball into touch safely. And there you see, there's the ball in front. And look how strong this wing Tugamala is. Just brushes one man off. There's another man off. But there's what his foot went into touch. Touches on the spot.
So we've not seen either trainer on the field this game. Just for Kerwin to leave the field. Really, it's been fast and furious throughout. Here, just a little bit of attention required by a Pontypool man. But for Pontypool, with now time fast running out as we enter the final quarter of the match, the difference 35 points, and perhaps the difference between not just Pontypool rugby, it might represent a broader field than that, and All Black rugby. And there we see Mr. Clive Rowlands as president. We have David Richards and David Bircher and Jeff Squire just behind him. Three of the big five, and at least they're saying an amusing side to it all.
And the All Blacks, even on a Pontypool ball, are dominating the lineup. Not great ball, Bashup does well, but for me, Fitzpatrick has probably been the pick of the forwards. He's been quite magnificent this afternoon, so strong. And look, number five there, and just watch, there's the flick pass, and this outstanding prospect, Ian Jones, he's over for a well-deserved try.
This is Botica's conversion then. And he, or Gallagher's conversion rather, he increases that lead then. It's now 41 points, Pontypool 6, New Zealand 47.
And there's the difference. You see any 50-50 ball, the All Blacks have taken it. And this man, Fitzpatrick, looks so strong, just shrugs the tacklers aside. There's a second row who takes it. He shows that he's mobile. And look, a man coming from deep, Ian Jones, plows his way over. What a prospect, number four.
Silver, the restart. Through comes Mosley, the captain. This is Graham Price, his first touch of the game. Now Pontypool on the charge, driven on again. Straight on, can they get a try? That would really lift their day. A day that's been all gloom up until now. 41 points adrift. The momentum broken though. Lots of pointing and finally out of steam.
That's better for Pontypool. That was a bit of pride. Mosley involved, Churchill involved, and Graham Price. Far better play by the forwards. And that stemmed again from not a bad kick out.
Pontypool scrum will want to exert pressure here. Advantage to the touring team. Being spoiled by Pontypool, they try and turn that, but Botica so assured. What a superb kick. Under pressure, made to measure. Again, Mr. Sterling asks for both lines to just disengage, to leave some light between them. That's Guardian Jenkins, the hooker. Taken at the back then, Pontypool have hands on the ball. Can they now take advantage as Jenkins drives blindside, laid back perfectly. Now into midfield, this is Silver on the scissors, but not well supported. It allows the All Blacks to come in, take it, allows Little to throw a little dummy. What a good tackle though, excellent tackle by Oswald, driven back. The All Blacks on the retreat, and the referee decides, much to Wright's disappointment, he fancied his chances running off that ruck situation. Minutes remaining then. 6 points to Pontypool. They decline at Potico. Again, it's the forwards through Hewish, the drive on. Again, runs into the solid wall of Purvis. Now it's laid back. A little bit of adventure. Support not quite there in numbers. And quick enough as well. Garin Jenkins shows his displeasure. He was knocked out of that ruck situation. two of the All Blacks taking their time to get to that scrum. Obviously feeling tired legs towards the end. Just 14 minutes remaining. Just a Pontypool man suffering an injury there. That's Dean Oswald, the All Black, who's really put in everything into this game. Really had a point to prove playing against his fellow countrymen. Just in the background there, Joe Stanley, who's had great influence on the way the All Blacks have played this game behind the scrum. The old head there with Little, the youngster, at his side. Really, it's a lovely combination that, not always the smoothest of runners, but so much vision. When Stanley plays, things happen.
Yes, he takes the pressure off the fly half because he's so strong, it gives it plenty of options to take.
Can Pontypool take advantage of this position then? It's on the All Black 22. This is right to Silva. Again, it's the little move in midfield. And again, straight into opposition defenders. Silva on the retreat. No sign of the ball as yet, but Wright finally gets it, goes on a little run. The kick is charged down, and Botica so quickly on that, taking Gareth Davis, but the whistle is gone. Offside, says the referee, offers Pontypool the option of whether they want a kick or a scrum. And Pontypool, not surprisingly, take the scrum just outside the 22.
Yes, I think they've got to work something with their back row. Hewish, Oswell and Goody, they look as if they can attack, because really behind the scrum, they're going to cross the field and New Zealand are sniffing them out.
Well, the man on that blind side, Twigamala, will have to be alert to this, because that's the favoured space as far as Pontypool is concerned.
And look at Zinzanbrook, he's standing out watching for any movement on that narrow side.
Wright decides, and before he had got that ball, Twigamala was on his way back to help Gallagher. Gallagher takes it well. Airborne as he takes it, and the referee quickly in and has seen a transgression from the Pontypool captain and calls him aside. Feet going in, and the Pontypool captain admonished and retreats the obligatory 10 metres.
And we saw Matthew Ridge on Saturday take some high balls for the All Blacks, and we saw there that Gallagher, he's no slouch, he was very brave, took it well, and the referee had seen some feet going in at the wrong way in the ruck.
Yes, Gallagher and Ridge on Saturday, following the example set by Roger Gould, the great Australian fullback. He was the man that pioneered this airborne attempt to catch the early ball, rather than waiting there and being swamped by oncoming forwards. They take it early, then they dominate the area, just as goalkeepers do. Change of tactics by Pontypool, then Hewish. A crunching tackle from Zinzanbrook, but the ball on his way back. This is Wright, probing on the blind side. Again, the little chip kick is charged down, but that was offside play by the All Blacks. But again, interesting to see that it's Gary Wetton standing off and defending.
But again, when they did take that two-man line-out, they gave Hewish a 50-50 chance of getting the ball at the back of the line-out. So I think they should do far more two-man and three-man line-outs. But as you say, Wetton was confident enough to stand out and take the tackle on the narrow side.
So again, with Jenkins as the pivot, he this time goes on a little run, dummies to the men coming on to him. Set back, this is Wright. Can Pontypool generate something? A long pass, but Wright really, yes, does very well to get fingers to that, but couldn't quite control it. So desperate stuff here from Pontypool. They've not really been in it right throughout from the beginning, and now with just 10 minutes remaining, trying to eat something. 6 points only to them thus far, 47 to the All Black touring team. The second match of the tour, the Stirling just asks the front rows to bind properly. That's the All Blacks 22 you see just in the background there. The referee again not satisfied. Now you see a good view of those front rows engaging. Pontypool putting pressure quickly up to Zinzanbrook to drive on. They now set it back. The Bashup is there, has possession. Botica, just the check, just the one look to pick his spot. And then no problem whatsoever. really they'll have problems with choosing their outs at half, perhaps with Fox not on Song on Saturday, and Botica proving such an interesting foil today, looking, probing all the time. Wetton then. This time won by Mosley. Silva in his own 10-metre line. McGarhill, or Gallagher, calls early. Starts on a run, good tackle by White. That means that the All Blacks are on the retreat there, and it's won by Potterpool. This is right. Space for Oral and Bidgood. Good tackling again by the All Blacks. That's Gallagher with a good tackle. This is Dean Oswald into the midfield, and Silva now starts on a run. Out there in midfield, good tackle by Little. And again, it's on the retreat as Potterpool try and mount an attack. And going away is Trigomala. Silva, lovely defensive work, but Little is on hand. And he, no, the pass was forward, says the referee. So Little, thinking that he would have got a second try in his first game in an All Black jersey. Disappointment of having to come back some 40 metres to a scrum.
And there was great tackling by the winger, Tugawala, that had set that up. He ripped the ball apart, but look very carefully, and there's where the referee said that was a forward pass.
It's the right-silver combination again then. And no adventure. The aim is to just work upfield. Silva, two penalty goals to his credit. So some consolation for him, not much for the team though, nor to the crowd in the background there, hoping to have seen something better offered by the home club. The All Blacks in tremendous form. It's been so quick as Bashup gets it into midfield. It wasn't straight, says the referee. And the gap in pace perhaps is the greatest one that's been driven home today, the fact that the game is played at such a quicker tempo.
Yes, but look at the confident New Zealand ass. Potterpool, such a good scrummaging side. But you can see, look, Zin Zambrook, number 8, he's standing on that narrow side, knowing that Potterpool go a lot in that way. He's very confident that the man can hold him in the scrum.
Potterpool will take that as the ultimate insult, that the opposition can stand their number 8 out in midfield and not bother with a scrum. And some feet going in that ruck situation. The referee is there on the spot. And the crowd displeased with it, and I wonder whether the touch judge, Mr. Hilditch, has come in fact, and of course on that far side Stephen Hilditch will know the All Black play so well. He was the man that refereed the Bledisloe Cup match during the summer between the All Blacks and Australia.
And look very carefully, it's a ruck ball. There's a Pontypool man there, he goes on the wrong side. Now we have to say to ourselves, is he killing the ball? You'll see Zin Zambrook come in shortly. There's the man there, he makes no attempt to go for the ball. He tries to ruck the man out of the way, and the referee says that he wasn't going for the ball, dangerous feet. There you can see him on the wrong side.
And Dean Oswald will leave the field with having suffered an injury there at the bottom of that ruck situation. That'll disappoint him, although as far as Potterpool are concerned, it'll offer Alan Carter a chance to go onto the field, and that will delight the local supporters. Some feeling here that an All Black or a New Zealander had got a game against his fellow countrymen to the exclusion of this young man, Alan Carter. But Carter is now on the field with number 21 on his back, and he'll want to quickly get involved. 5 minutes this man has to stamp his mark on this game, which is nothing really. He's watched going through agonies probably from the bench as his team has suffered, now involved at last. That's the All Black 22, and the referee Stirling again quickly in, this time penalising Pontypool. Really, with lineouts as they are, it's very difficult to know who's transgressing. It's very much six of one and half a dozen of the others. But there, the referee decides it's Pontypool's turn to be penalised. Botica. Again, no heroics at all. They feel they've done their work. They've reached 47 points. And they won't expect many more points than that against Pontypool. Really, it was such an impressive first half. 31 points during that 40 minutes. Again, the variation at the line-out from Pontypool, but Earl is there, unopposed, offside as well. That's why he was unopposed, perhaps. And can Pontypool now generate some momentum, take it quickly, but it's all so slow. And they decide that that's the All Black bench. Richard Lowe, a try-scorer on Saturday with a bag in his hand, quite pleased with things, obviously. So Silva has given them a chance again. He's driven the All Blacks back inside their own 22, but of course the advantage is the opposition's. 21 at the back there, newly arrived on the field is Alan Carter, former captain of the Welsh Secondary Schools, of course. Six in front of him is Chris Hewish. Mosley is five. Six for the All Blacks was Earl. He's the man that won that, not tidily, but quickly through. Is Walter Little again, the pass to Stanley, in support is McGarhill, this is Gallagher with space, lovely tackle, all embracing from Sean White. Really he's not had the ball in his hands this afternoon, but what a good tackle from White. Set up his man, allowed him the outside, and really Gallagher hoping to get into that space on the outside,
and there's
comprehensively done.
And there's Gallagher, as you say, good play by the winger, showing him the outside. Gallagher's very quick, going there, but a tremendous tackle by Sean White, and he drives the New Zealand fullback into touch.
Referee not satisfied that the ball was thrown in straight at the line-out. The All Black decide on a scrum. Six on this side is Andy Earl. The control is from Brooke. This is Bashir Bottiker. Stanley, three huge passes, but Tugamala collected as Joe Stanley finds the space back towards strength. Next to him is Wetton, runs out of space. The pass, well, not the best pass. Henderson failed to gather it, nudged it forward, and what a shame, because really Stanley again looks slightly ungainly, but finds space in an uncanny manner.
Yes, he broke a lot of tackles there, good running, but I'm sure Wiley will be disappointed as coach because the pass went astray. And look, Stanley's so strong, little support on his right-hand side, so he hands off and he's saying, where's my support? So he goes to look back inside. He could have put the short pass, but saw there were men there, and there's where the ball was knocked forward.
Right, has a little look before finally kicking. It's into, well, into touch. It's being guarded by both Tugamala and Gallagher. We're into the final 2 minutes of the game then. The difference, 41 points. The All Blacks putting their tour comprehensively on the road. It was a bit of a stuttering opening on Saturday. Today, no doubts at all. The referee not satisfied with that delivery from the line-out. That's the Pontypool bench, and stern-faced John Perkins. Graham Pritchard, his assistant, next to him. Really, it's not been their day. All their preparations, a long session on Monday night. Perhaps too long a session, and much of the enthusiasm was killed at that stage. Silva, the kick into space. Will Tugamala have a run? Yes, he will. Over the 22, the support in the shape of Gallagher. Space and pace. Bottiker, disappointing hands as Walter Little takes it on. And that won't please Gallagher. Such assured play from him. And finally, the referee, the whistle from Brian Stirling. A final scoreline of Pontypool 6, New Zealand 47. You couldn't ask for a more comprehensive statement from the All Blacks and their intentions on this tour as the captain, today's captain, Gary Wetton, much to his relief and delight, I'd have thought, has led his side to this 41-point clear margin over Pontypool. The home side, old crowd rather, just disappointed that they didn't see their home side raised to the occasion. But the All Blacks, Phil Bennett, no doubting that they now have got their tour properly on the road.
This was a great performance this afternoon. Pontypool will be devastated. Perkins and Posse for years have taught the basics so well. They've destroyed sides of here, but today they were destroyed by a marvellous New Zealand 8. And behind the scrum, as I've said earlier, Bottiker, Little and Stanley exploited the possession to the full. they posted a warning to the rest of Welsh rugby. The Tours on the road again.
And just having a look at the Pontypool side, they've always set the All Blacks up as the gods here. They've tried to emulate them, and they didn't quite come off today.
No, not really. They couldn't win the possession. The All Blacks seemed stronger up front. They sort of they were dominant. Jones, Wetton won the line out. The back row there far quicker than Pontypool. And really, the young halfbacks, they felt the pressure. Wright didn't kick well. Silver missed touches, and the pressure was far too great. But I was very pleased with the All Blacks' back play because they know what it's all about when they have the ball.
That combination of Stanley and Little in the centre, that was encouraging, Phil.
Oh, yes. I think they're going to say that when they get Schuster back there. But this Little, he's gone for a place. He showed today that he can take his chances. And I think we're going to see a lot more of this midfield combination as the tour goes on.
Well, 8 tries and down on the touchline, we have Alan Wilkins, who is now going to talk to the New Zealand captain.
We're having a bit of a problem here getting hold of Kevin Moses, the Pontypool captain. Kevin, great support, but you gave it everything on the day.
Very disappointed on the day. We started very slow, but the time we got going, it was far too late. Though.
They got off to a hell of a start. 4 tries in 17 minutes. That was difficult to come back from.
Too good a start, really. We had no answer to that. Far too good a team for us on the day.
We thought the Pontypool challenge might just have been a bit bigger on the day.
Very disappointed, really. It's all over now. We're just allowed to get on with the rest of the season.
Kevin, ominous signs for Swansea and then for Wales.
Very ominous, I'm afraid, for Swansea. Not so much for Wales. I think we can pull together and give them a game, you know.
Kevin, in your honest opinion, how good are these All Blacks?
Well, they're a very good team, you know. They showed how good they was today, I think.
But for Pontypool's Bonnaboy, what have you got to say for the boys?
The boys give it everything, and once we pull together, we put up a better show in the second half, so much as I can ask for, you know.
Kevin, thanks a lot. Kevin Moseley, Pontypool captain.
Well, that was Kevin Moseley, the Pontypool captain. Really difficult times for him, to having gone through an experience such as that, having suffered a defeat as heavy as that, and then to face the cameras, it takes a brave man. And Moseley will have a second bite perhaps at the cherry when he plays for, or he'll hope to play for Wales against the All Blacks. Not his first experience of this sort of thing, of course, because he spent a season or a summer with the Bay of Plenty and of course toured with Wales in New Zealand in 88. So really, for him, it was not a new experience. The hopes, though, I would have thought, Phil Bennett of his team dashed there. And perhaps if Pontypool can't raise to the occasion as far as forwards are concerned, then it doesn't say a great deal about Welsh rugby.
No, really, because they are one of the senior packs in Welsh rugby. But you know, we all the same Wales, we've got world-class players. Well, I saw what Steve McDowell could play today. I saw what Sean Fitzpatrick were like. They were surely world-class. Wetton was world-class. Zinzambrook, really today, sorry, it was men against boys, and New Zealand absolutely destroyed them. And what a warning for Swansea, who lost up here about 30-odd points a couple of weeks ago.
Well, it was 8 tries for the All Blacks. They led at half-time by 31-3. At the end of the day, Gallagher scored 19 points. There were 8 tries for the All Blacks. Pontypool, it was 2 penalties to Silver, the outside half. So at the end of the day, it's victory in the second match of the tour for the All Blacks. The final scoreline, Pontypool 6, New Zealand 47.